Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making spiced cashews, and I'm still making some treats for you for your Super Bowl party. Not everybody has a Super Bowl party. That's not the sport of everyone, but a lot of people in the U.S. are just looking for a reason to have a party. So sports events are nice times to do that, and you like to have things to munch on. So this is something that's a little sweet and a little spicy, and I think you'll like it. So we're starting with cashews, and I've already emptied out my bag, so I've got 2 cups of whole cashews. If you have cashew halves, that would be fine, but we're going to use 2 cups of those. And you'll notice the package that I have, if you can read that, it says roasted and salted cashews. Now I am going to be roasting these, and they also call for salt. So if you get the kind that is unsalted and unroasted, then I'll tell you how to adapt. You'll go ahead and roast it just like we're going to do ours. So ours are double roasted, but you'll have to add more salt than I will, since I have some salted cashews. Now they're not too salty, so I do want to add a little bit for ours. So let's get that out of the way. And then we're going to add, I guess we'll add our butter next. We have 2 tablespoons of salted butter that I've melted on top of the stove. And we'll just pour that in, drizzle it over the top. Next comes some sugar, just granulated sugar, 1/8 cup. And so that just comes up to the 1 ounce mark on my measure here. Just sprinkle 1/8 cup of sugar. That's gonna make them a little sweet. And to balance that off, we're gonna have spicy and salty. The salt I've chosen here is Atlantic sea salt. And if you have unsalted cashews, use 1/2 teaspoon. I'm just going to do a grinding, since I have salted cashews already. I'm just going to put a little bit, don't need too much there. Now for the spicy, I have red pepper. And you need to go easy on this. I'm just going to put 1/8 teaspoon. Now if you're sure you can handle more than that, then you could go up to 1/4. But I definitely would not go beyond 1/4 teaspoon. Put that in. And then we have one last thing before we stir this together, and that's Worcestershire sauce. We're going to use 2 teaspoons. So I'll just measure this out. There's 1. And the 2nd 1. Now, let me take a little break and get something to stir this with. I'll be right back. I got my spoon, and I got these stirred up. And you can see that it's kind of has a coating because the Worcestershire sauce was liquid, and that allowed everything to stick on very nicely. So what we're going to do is just put it in some kind of pan that you have greased. And I've taken a 13x9x2 Pyrex dish just so I would have plenty of space to spread them out, and I've sprayed with cooking oil spray. Use any kind of spray you want, or use butter and just take your fingers and put it in there. But it does need some kind of greasing on the bottom. And then put these in. You want them to be pretty much in a single layer, but just kind of rake them in and let them go in different directions. And I think this 13x9x2 is fine for this amount. If you decide to double this, you probably still could do it in 13x9x2. If you have 4 times as much, depending on the size of party you're having and the number of people you're having over, then you may get some doubling up of the layers, and that's not really too desirable, so you probably just need to do it twice, or a bigger pan. But you want them spread out about like that in whatever pan you use. And then they're going into an oven, which is heated to 350 degrees, and we're going to let this toast for 10 to 12 minutes. Now, mine are already roasted, so I might decide to take mine out a little earlier. If yours were not roasted at all, then you'll probably want to leave them 10 to 12 minutes. Don't let them burn is the main thing. So just keep an eye on them, and if they start to look brown, then you get them out of there, because they shouldn't be brown. They should just be nice and honey colored and nice and toasted. So into the oven, and I'll show you what they look like when they come out. These have just come out of the oven, and I want to tell you that I left them for 10 minutes because they had been roasted before, and I felt like they didn't need the 12 minute time period. I did stir them twice during the baking because you want them to get that coating and you want them turned over as well. So a couple times I would go in and do this and then spread them right back out. Now the thing to do after you get them out and they're hot like this is to have already prepared a pan, or you could actually put it on your countertop if you wanted to, but I would rather not harm my countertop. So I need wax paper that I'm going to put it on, and it's easy for me just to line a pan with it and then dip these out and let them cool. Now as soon as they are cool, then we'll be sprinkling sugar over the top. So I'll come back for that last step and show you that in a minute. Our spicy cashews have had a chance to cool, and you can see you can handle them because they are not hot. They're a little bit warm. Some of them you'll see like this have the Worcestershire sauce mixture that has kind of glazed the top of them, and that just gives you a nice spicy taste there if you get one of those. But not all of them are like that. In looking at what I have here, I think I probably should have gone maybe 2 minutes less. I should have stopped at 8 instead of going to 10 minutes, but just do it to your taste. You need to have them toasted. If you want them lightly toasted, then don't go as long as the 10 minutes. If you want them toasted quite a lot and they weren't toasted to begin with, then you'll let them go longer. So let's just try to, well, now there's one more step before I put them in my serving bowl, and that is once they're cooled, spread them out, and then I have 1/2 teaspoon of sugar. So you're going to just sprinkle them with sugar. And then what I was trying to do was kind of roll this up in a fashion where I could slide them all out at once into the bowl. Let's see if this works. Here we go. I don't know if the bowl will hold them. If not, then I'll just keep the rest back here in my hand. I'll just dip the rest. I think this is something that you'll enjoy at a party, but also if you're just home watching a movie or something, watching TV, they're great to munch on. And they're not as bad as candy or anything like that because they have a lot of protein in them. In general, you think of cashews as being a healthy food, but if that's your complete diet, of course, it's not that great. But I hope you enjoy them.